Hello and welcome everyone. On this video tutorial for chapter Reproduction in Animals. Basically, let me deal with animals. Animals can produce their young ones in two forms. Either they can lay eggs or they can directly give birth to the young one. Okay, so what we do is we have divided it into two parts, oviparous and viviparous. Oviparous means those who give eggs, who lay eggs, like hen, birds, I should say all birds and all reptiles. They give eggs, so they are oviparous. But those who give birth to the young ones, like human beings and rats and all other mammals, they are known as viviparous. Okay, oviparous and viviparous. Now, first question which should arise in the mind is, why reproduction? What is the sole and sole purpose of reproduction? The nature, our mother nature, has arranged everything for everyone. And also, mother nature wants each and every species which it has created to survive. And for the survival of a species, it is necessary for every species to reproduce. For example, a plant, suppose a tree, apple tree. Apple tree has grows apple, and that apple has seeds. These seeds are very much needed. These seeds are very much needed for new plant to grow. This is the way how nature helps in spreading a species around everywhere. Okay, similarly, when we are talking about or when we are dealing about human beings or any other species or any other animals, they reproduce so that they should survive on this planet. They reproduce in order to survive on this planet. Okay, they reproduce so that the new ones can explore the new areas and new grounds where they can live. Understood? So, in order to do the reproduction, basically we are talking about humans in this chapter. So, when we are dealing with humans, humans are divided into all the mammals are divided into two parts, males and females. All the mammals are divided into two parts, one is male and one is female. No matter whatever the female is, and no matter whatever the male is, they reproduce. Gametes. These gametes can be sperms, and in female it will be ovum. In male it is sperms, and in female it is ovum. So gamete are sperms and ovum. In some books or in some reference books, ovums are even referenced as eggs. Eggs are produced inside the female body, so there is no issue with that. But we don't use eggs because we have a proper word for that. That is ovum. So sperms and ovum. So when we are dealing with gamete, sperms and ovum. Sperms for male, ovum for female. Now, where are these produced? Where is this ovum and sperms are produced? Sperms are produced inside testis, and ovum is produced inside ovary. So they are known as gonads. They are known as gonads. So human being, male, female, male has testes, ovaries has females, and testes produce sperms and ovaries produce ovum. Now, you should know that this is something for your GK or you get a general knowledge. Sperms is the smallest cell for human being. Sperms is the smallest cell for human being, and ovum is the largest cell for human being. Ovum is the largest cell on human being, and the ovum or the egg of ostrich is the largest cell on our planet. Is the largest cell on our planet. Okay, so before moving further, if you check out on your book, then you have this male and female reproductive systems. So what happens is, there are a few which is not inside your book. Male and female both have urogenital tract. Male and female both have urogenital tract. The meaning of this urogenital tract is that we pass our urine and genital material both through same passage. Males and females both use our same passage for urine and you can say for their gametes and all these things. Understood? So that's why we call it urogenital tract. Now, moving further, urinary, the first part is the cap-like structure which is here is urinary bladder. Bladder is a part of excretory system. Bladder is very much necessary inside our body because bladder holds all the urine created from the kidneys. Bladder holds all the urine which is created through kidneys, and once it's filled, then you get the urge there that you have to take out all the urine, you have to pass out all the urine from your body. So that is the purpose of bladder. Just below the bladder, we have this seminal vesicle gland that makes a liquid medium for sperm. Now, sperm is created inside testes. Okay, sperm is created inside testes. Testes, the male gonads are paired structure responsible for production of male gamete, sperm, and hormone testosterone. Okay, regarding testosterone and other hormones, I will after this video I will create that video for you. But first of all, regarding testes, testes are especially outside the male body. Testes are outside the male body, and their sole and sole purpose is to generate sperms. But sperms need something when it is inside a female's body. That sperm needs some nutrition because the lifespan of sperm is not too much large. Okay, and the sole purpose of sperm is to find an ovum, match with it, and start the fertilization. So, for that, just to make sure that when the sperm is in female body, it should reach from to the egg alive. This seminal vesicle is there. What its purpose is? It's generate or it's produce liquid medium which have nutritive and all other things, basic nature, which helps in keeping the sperm alive during reproduction. Now, next is vas deferens. Sperms are generated somewhere. Now, when the sperms are generated inside testes, they have to be taken out. So, what is the path or what is the duct which they use is vas deferens. Then, next is urethra. Duct carries the semen and the seminiferous vesicle to the exterior. Okay, so this is the diagram which you should understand. Now, when we are dealing with female reproductive system, then female reproductive system is quite very simple. It has ovaries. Inside ovary, that ovum is produced. Now, I said that in testes, sperms are generated. In testes, sperms are generated. But in ovary, that ovums are not generated. When the females, I would say the child inside the mother's womb, when that girl child is, female child is inside mother's womb, at that moment, inside ovaries, there are millions of eggs or ovums which are already generated, which are already created. Now, at the time of puberty, when the female become mature, these ovums started maturing also. Okay, so at a time of reproduction, reproductive age, every ovary, there are two ovaries inside female, every ovary produce one egg or ovum at a time or within a difference of 1 month. So one ovary will work for 1 month, then another ovary will work for 1 month, and vice versa till the menopause stage. So I need not worry about menopause, I will explain it what is it. So this is the way how things happen. So inside the female reproductive part, you have ovary which produces you can say female gonad and pair structure responsible for production of ovum and hormone estrogen. Okay, estrogen, sorry. So inside ovaries are connected through fallopian tube or ovida. Ovaries are connected through fallopian tube or ovida. Now, I said that inside sperms, inside testes, they have a method to take it out. Okay, so this is the duct which is there. Similarly, when we talk about ovary, it has fallopian tube which collects ovum from here and it is kept here. Once the sperm is there and it attaches with the egg, it gets fertilized. Then that sperm is taken out inside the uterus from fallopian tube. From fallopian tube, it is taken inside the uterus, inside here at this point, and you can say there is a sticky layer where it sticks down, and hence the embryo formation and everything after zygote process. I will tell you what is it, zygote and everything which happens after it starts forming. Okay, so this is the way how thing works. So moving on to the further. Female gamete formation. So when we are talking about gamete formation, basically all of us, look, you all know about chromosomes. Okay, this is a similar type of structure which a chromosome should have. So every organism on this earth has its own chromosome. Okay, chromosomes has genes which are just replicated, generally inside our other cells, for example in our skin cell, in our cells of cheek, in onions, the chromosomes are, they just got multiplied, they generally get multiplied. But in terms of why do we call it gamete, because they are haploid, that is they have only the half portion, of this chromosome. Because what nature has done is half should be from male part and half should be from female part. When this half and half will join, it will make it a complete of one. So that is the reason you have characters from your mother as well as characters from your father. Now, what is the purpose of this reproduction, which include two partners, that is should have two, one male and one female? The purpose is, suppose you are at a photocopy shop, and during having a photocopy of one page, one of the hair or some fine dust got into it between, maybe between pages or maybe on the screen. But now whatever printout you will get will have this type of damage on the screen, or whatever the printout you will receive will have that damage. So whole of the species is now damaged. That's why photocopy is not at all always the best answer for any you can say reproduction. But when we are having one from male and one from female, so we get the opportunity for getting multiple things, multiple changes. Okay, that is the reason insects which were primitive, which we found in the fossils, are still the same. But humans have evolved to a huge amount. Once we were inside the, you can say, there was a time when the humans were inside the sea, or when the sea or inside water, when we were amphibians. From amphibians we become terrestrial, that is, we become monkeys, and from monkeys we gradually changed into apes, and apes to the, you can say, human beings. Okay, so this whole process was able to follow because of this system, that change is the part of life. Understood? So what is written here? All cells in the human body have 46 chromosomes in the nucleus. These cells are diploid cells. Chromosomes contain genes like this, diploid cells. Okay, similarly, every cell will have 46 chromosomes. Chromosomes contain genes, the blueprint of the responsible for determining the characteristics of an individual. Okay, you have seen multiple people with green eyes. I have seen one person who is having multiple colors in his eyes. For example, half his eye was one fourth of his eye is red, then it's blue and then side is greenish. Okay, and similarly both the eyes are having the same situation. Then
it got stuck to the uterus lining. Okay, it
constitute the uterus lining, where it is preserved and a placenta is created and a huge amount of things happen simultaneously, which are only to make sure that the baby should grow. The baby inside the mother's womb should grow. Okay. Now, this information you should know. A female uterus is normally about 3 inches along the 2 inches wide, which can expand up to 20 times during pregnancy. 20 times. This will be. A female ovary is not more than this size. It is generally the size of like this. Okay. It can grow up to 20 times to have the baby inside it. Okay, on the full maturity, the baby comes out of the mother's womb by the process called parturition. And I have told you that gestation period is the human being around 62 to 70 days, around 9 to 10 months it is. And once the baby is full grown up, it should be taken out. Now, you all have seen that when the moment baby comes out of the mother's body, it starts crying. You all have seen and observed that the moment, even in movies you have also seen that every time the child is born, it starts crying, and every one starts like, oh, the baby is so good, it's crying. Why does it cry? But because yet there is the reason that he is taken out from the womb, now he is, okay, I'm taken out, I should cry. No, actually, when the baby is taken out of the mother's body, what actually happens at that moment is, he was not at all using his nose to breathe. At that time, the baby was not using his nose to breathe. Till the time baby is inside mother's womb, it is inside a liquid. Okay, this liquid provides all the nutrition to the baby to grow. And baby is connected to the mother with an umbilical cord from the center of your stomach. Okay, that transfers all the nutrients directly from mother to the baby body. So baby doesn't need to have oxygen and anything when it's inside. But the moment it is taken out, now baby need it from surroundings. Now baby need oxygen from the surrounding, from the atmosphere. So it when the first time when the baby tries to stretch its you can say rib cages. Okay, it is the first time his rib cage starts moving, and the pain is obviously it's very large. So because of that pain, baby starts crying. Because of the first movement of the rib cage, baby has feels the pain and it starts crying. Okay, now moving on to the next, determination of sex of baby. Okay, so this is a very important thing you should know. Thank you. either x or either can be y. So when x meets x from the female, when x meets x from the female, we get female. Okay, and when y meets x, so it it will be male. Okay, when x meets x, it will be female, and when y meets x, it will be female. So xx and yx, these are the only two combinations which are possible. Previously it was thought that it is the female who is responsible, but no, it is the actual male who can produce either x or y from that is sperms. So males are the only one who is responsible for it. That is determination of sex. And in India, sex determination before the birth of the child is a what we call it, under, it's not allowed under the law. It's not allowed under the law, and it is taken considered as a crime. It is considered as a crime. Okay, so moving to the further next part. Modes of reproduction and development in other animals. Okay, so I told you that this whole is about the male, female, and it is termed as sexual reproduction. They perform asexual reproduction. For example, the first example is given of amoeba. What happens in amoeba? You don't need to think about any shape of amoeba. The shape of amoeba can be anything. Now, this is the cell of amoeba. What can happen? The nucleus will start dividing into two parts. It will start dividing into two parts. Soon enough, two nucleus are produced. Now, eventually, this cytoplasm will also break and new cells are generated. We call it daughter cells. This is the way how amoeba get divided. And in some case, or like Hydra, Hydra is also very insidious, because Hydra is something like this, you can see. Okay, now, what Hydra does is, grows a bud. Now it wants to produce a new one, it will start producing a bud. This bud will resembles like the same of Hydra. Once the bud is mature, it will release out it from its body. Now this was already there, now this new is generated. This is the way Hydra will produce. So asexual reproduction of Hydra is budding. Okay, this method is what? Budding. A bud was produced. Even the yeast you eat, yeast which is massively used for preparing cakes and biscuits, yeast also have this type of bud formation, and from bud a new cell is generated. In amoeba, bud two daughter cells are created. Okay, it is what? Binary fission. Next is after these two, next is fertilization. Okay, what we may have left here is when we call about fertilization can happen in two forms. It can be internal fertilization or it can be external fertilization. For example, when we are talking about human beings, we do the internal fertilization, because egg is ovum is inside the mother's fallopian tube, where sperms reach and they make a zygote. So everything is happening inside the body. Everything is happening inside the body. So we will call it internal fertilization. And for example, when we are taking examples of frogs and many fishes, what happens is fish will produce ovum in the water, and the male will produce in the water. Inside water, these sperms and ovum will match and they will make a zygote. So both of the things are outside the body. Both the things are outside the body. So they will, this type of fertilization is called external fertilization. When sperm meet the egg inside the body, when the sperm meets the ovum inside the body, we call it internal fertilization. When they both meet outside the body, we call it external fertilization. Do not get confused between oviparous or viviparous, because in both OV and VV, I will say internal fertilization is there. In both oviparous and viviparous, internal fertilization is there, because sperm has to reach inside the egg, inside the uterus of the female, and from there egg is generated or from there baby is generated. Okay, so in both situations you have to be very much careful what you are breeding. Okay, so after internal and external fertilization, oviparous and viviparous, it's already explained. Okay, now the most important use of technology in reproduction. Previously you have seen I will not say much on this topic. That you already have seen movies like Good News. You have already seen movie like Good News. It was completely based on test tube baby. Test tube baby doesn't mean that baby is produced inside test tube and then the baby is created and that baby is given to look. After test tube ka baby ho gaya, le jao. No, baby is and baby have to be inside the mother's womb. What actually happens is, in certain some cases, in cases where females, you can say ovary is not able to do the proper ovulation, or it can be because of hormones, or it can be because of any tension or any type of XYZ disease. If the female, female's body, ovary is not able to produce eggs or ovum in the proper form manner, or if the male sperms are not able to reach the female's body, inside body, or XYZ there can be reason. So what generally the doctors do is, they take out the egg from the mother's body, they will take out the that sperms from the male's body, and they will in the test tube they will make them match. Now a zygote is created. Once the zygote is created, that zygote is taken and it is placed inside mother's uterus. It is placed inside mother's uterus, and the moment it is placed inside mother's uterus, nature will do all other things. Nature will follow all other things. So this is the way how test tube baby is, or IVF, in vitro fertilization, is used. Okay, so I should say it is a boon for multiple families where normal delivery, or I should say normal fertilization, is not possible. Okay, and this is the same method which was utilized to generate clones. In multiple fictitious movies or science movies, you have seen that a clone is there. I can make my clone. Yes, I can make my clone. For making a clone, I only need a hair, or even you can say a drop of my sweat is more than enough to create a clone. But till now, we do not have that much technology to generate. Look, what will happen? If I am producing a clone, that clone also has to take birth from the mother's body. That clone has also to take birth from the mother's body. So if there is a clone of mine, right now my age is 30. So that clone will be 30 years less than me. So it will need 30 years to be of my age or my height and everything. That is sure that clone will have all the characters like me, or at least physical characters like me. Mentally can be other, but physical characters like me. For example, if I am having this mole here, the clone will also have the same thing, same. Everything will be similar. Understood? So that is the topic of cloning. Okay. One thing now you should know here is, metamorphosis. When in human beings, so
suppose if I talk about a cow, when the calf is born, the calf very much resembles to the, either you can say cow or the ox. It resembles, it looks very same. But in some organisms, the first one form is doesn't look like the parents. For example, in terms of, if I take the example of butterfly, you have already studied about silk moth. The larva which is produced, it doesn't look similar. It do not even look similar. Its even face is not looking similar to the parent, you can say butterfly, or the silk moth which is completely adult silk moth, I should say. So, in situations where the first young which is produced doesn't look like the adult, and they keep on doing generating their body, okay, now and take multiple stages before becoming an adult, we call it metamorphosis. For example, look at the example of the tadpole. Male frog look like this. Male frogs give eggs. These eggs enter embryo. But the tadpole, it look like fish. The tadpole look like fish. In rainy seasons, if you have seen a patch where water is there, you will be able to find these tadpoles inside the water. Okay, those tadpoles are having two legs. When these tadpoles then grow four, two more legs, or you should say two more limbs, and then it start looking like a actual frog. And once it is the big frog, the tail will disappear, and once the frog is mature, I should say, it become adult, his tail will be completely gone. Okay, so this is the way how things happen. Even in mosquito also these things happen. In butterflies, mosquitoes, frogs, and there are n number of examples where who follow this metamorphosis. Okay, that their young ones do not have the structure or the design, physical design, as like the adult one. So they go through multiple stages from where they produce or they look like similar to the adult ones. So because of multiple stages, we call this metamorphosis. Okay.